Wisconsin Broadcasters Association Hall of Famer Bob Berry ruled Milwaukee's airwaves in the 60s and 70s. He spoke with countless musicians and celebrities over the years. Bob collected remarkable recordings of these encounters, which he's now sharing with the public. Here's Bob.
The Titanic sank on April 15th, 1912, 109 years ago this month. We spoke with one of the survivors of this tragedy. In 1911, Marshal Drew had sailed with his aunt and uncle on the RMS Olympic to visit family in England. The voyage home began in Southampton on April 10, 1912, aboard the maiden voyage of the Olympic's sister ship, the Titanic. Marshall was very generous with his time, and he seemed very pleased to tell his story.
Today is the anniversary of the sinking of the Titanic. It struck the iceberg on a maiden voyage leaving England for the United States on April 14, 1912, but it sank on the 15th. And Marshall Drew, one of the few survivors of the Titanic disaster, is on the air with us right now. How old were you, and do you remember exactly what happened, Marshall?
I was 8 years old, and I do remember it very vividly.
Can you tell us exactly what happened?
Well, I can tell you my own experience, which was I was in a stateroom and with an uncle and aunt, and I was aware of the thud as the Titanic sliced into the iceberg, and we were dressed and had life preservers on and left the stateroom. A watertight compartment door, which was adjacent, was closed. The elevators were not running. We walked up to the top deck where the lifeboats were, and there was women and children first, of course.
Mm-hmm.
My uncle was left and drowned, and my aunt and I got into the lifeboat, and then, of course, it was lowered down the ship and rowed away. However, there's a lot of details connected with all this, but it's 70 feet down the side of one of these liners, so that liner anyway, and the descent was not anticipated, and everything was sticking and not working, and it was the only time I was frightened. I thought the whole lifeboat was going to be upset, but it made it.
Were there any sounds from the ship at all after you got in the lifeboat and got away from the ship?
Well, we rolled away quite a distance to it was the thought of every one of these lifeboats that they would be affected by suction when the liner sank, which didn't happen, but we rolled a distance away, and I remember seeing row after row of porthole lights descend into the sea until the first top deck, open deck, was awash. And then there seemed to be an explosion. But anyway, there was smoke and sparks and fire, and the ship upended and sank bow first. And at this point, it should be remembered, this is a dark night with only stars and very calm water, and the ship sank out of sight, and all was blacked out. And then we heard cries of hundreds of people, screams across the water, and then all was quiet, and that was that.
How long did it take before you were rescued?
Until the next morning, being picked up by the liner Carpathia. Well, I slept all night on life preservers, and I woke in the morning to look over the gunwale, and I could see icebergs 360 degrees so that it looked like the Arctic Circle. And investigation afterwards proved there were 25 huge icebergs in that vicinity.
Mm.
I'm sure people can visualize how much of an iceberg is underwater. A great, perhaps 9/10 of it is. So if they could picture the iceberg which the Titanic struck being 100 feet above the water, how far do you think it was below the water?
Now, they only saw the tip of the iceberg, so I guess they thought it wasn't too bad till they got up close to it.
Well, the lookouts were, of course, up in the crow's nest, and it was a dark night and they couldn't see very well. And ordinarily there would be a silhouette shape, but they couldn't make it out until it was too late. And the ship sailed in such a hurry that these poor guys in the crow's nest didn't even have binoculars.
Jeez, can you imagine that?
I suppose you know there was a liner called the Californian, some distance away, 8 or 10 miles, which some of the officers and crew saw rockets go up from the Titanic around midnight, and still this ship sailed away. And it's quite a story. That's a very interesting story.
Hmm. Did they ever find out the reason they sailed away?
Well, that's the point. It's the family of the captain of that ship tried to clear his name for 50 or 60 years, so you can imagine. This is quite a story.
Okay, Mr. Drew, thank you very much for talking with us.
Well,
appreciate it.
Talking to you, Bob.
Have a good day.
You too.
Thank you.
Bob Berry.
Thank you for listening to Bob Berry's Unearthed Interviews. Be sure to subscribe and rate our podcast on iTunes or wherever you find your podcasts. You can find all the episodes at WisconsinBroadcastingMuseum.org. Check out Bob Berry's book, Rock and Roll Radio Milwaukee. Book sale proceeds support Angels Kids Fund and Donate Life Wisconsin. The preceding program was made possible by a generous contribution from Terry Bond.